There's no question that South Asian music has gone mainstream. You're hearing it in the clubs, you're hearing it at the mall, and it's blasting from people's cars. But back in the 1990s, South Asian music was pretty unheard of. That is until one British Punjabi man took ragamuffin music and Indian music and combined it to make his own hybrid sound. His songs, Chakde and Arranged Marriage, were at the top of the chart for weeks, and people were jamming to his beat. Apache Indian is in town for the first time after 6 years, and I'm going to get the chance to chat with him one-on-one. Let's go inside and check it out.
You don't know, sir.
So much success.
Oh yeah.
And with your first album, with No Reservations, were you surprised by that?
No, I was absolutely surprised. Yeah. No, because the songs are just very simple, just reflecting my growing up in the UK, in Birmingham, mixture of reggae and in the Indian. So it's very personal. So the fact that people liked that after that, it's a blessing. It's fantastic, but I couldn't really understand it immediately. It just reflects, you know, Birmingham, Indian, Punjabi, reggae, personal tastes. So I knew people would like it, but you know, internationally,
yeah,
it was surprising,
it just
blew up. But fantastic. At the time,
because there was a lot of racism back in the day, and
that's right.
I think it was around 92, 93, and then with your music, I remember back in high school, it just made things feel so much more diverse and more accepting of other cultures.
That's right. You know, people said that we broke down barriers. You know, brought people together. All of a sudden, you had gigs where you know you had black people, white people, Asia, everyone coming together under the same roof. And if the music, you know, did something towards that, fantastic. But I definitely knew growing up, you know, as an Indian in the UK back from the 70s and 80s, we needed to see people on the scene. You know, I mean, we live in the country. We want to be on TV. We want to be in the charts. We want to be on radio. And we never saw that, you know, so I couldn't really say that I had any names to look up to apart from the names that were moved back from India or the reggae names that moved from Jamaica. But so in that respect, it was important. But not important just to write songs, but the kind of songs that you're talking about. You know, I wrote songs about arranged marriages, I wrote songs about caste system, AIDS, things that perhaps taboo subjects in our culture, in our community. And I wanted to do it in a different way, in the reggae way that I love so much, but still remembering who I was. So all these elements.
Walk across the land that has been chosen, and I shall climb the mountain so high. I shall go across the sea and ocean and sing with the bird in the sky.
You've been making music for years now. How do you keep it so that you're inspired and it's fresh?
Oh, yeah? I think just travelling around, you know, that's the greatest thing. The first album, it was just a definite reflection of the UK and staying. But since then, I've been around the world, picking up a lot of influences. I've toured 18 years, most countries, most cities and states, all over America, Canada, Japan, Middle East, India, Pakistan, everywhere. I think, you know, that's broadened my, just everything about life experiences, music, sounds, cultures, languages, everything, trying to keep it really and play the music.
Number one upon the Bombay chart, India and me, I tear them apart, when we come, we bring a new style, so listen, ragamuffin, tell everybody, them a bar for the one man
liquor,
ragamuffin, yo. Style. Fantastic. You're watching Monica right here in Omni with me, Apache Indian. You know, we keep it real, we keep it positive. It's all unity in the community. Don't you move it.
Yeah.
Well, this is the original Apache Indian back from them case again.
Yeah.
With a brand new style and trend.
Be sure to tune in my entertainment segment tomorrow, as I'll bring you part two of my sit-down interview with Apache Indian. And I'll also be chatting with Apache's son, Caveview, who's following his father's footsteps into music. I'm Alka Dover, and that's the Rapa Entertainment. As promised, here's a second part of my interview with the legendary singing sensation, Apache Indian.
And with your first album, I mean, you basically made being South Asian cool. The time the community was really struggling to find itself, was that just such a blessing? Or, I mean, what did you
think? No, again, I can't say that I went out there trying to achieve that. But I'm amazing to be able to have done that. And I'm just going against the grain a little bit. You know, I'm Indian, born in the UK. I have lots of influences around me. I come from a place, Birmingham, which is a lot of reggae influences. UB40 are from Birmingham. I have my sounds and language from home. So it seemed more natural for me to put all those elements together, as well as the pop music that you're hearing kind of subconsciously and hip hop and everything. So all that was just, you know, all the influences. When I went to the studio, I said, why can't I use all these influences?
I'm here with Apache Indian's son, Kayview, and I have to ask you, growing up, and Apache Indian being your dad, you know, what was that like growing up? Did you go out on tour with him?
Yeah, I was always out on tour with him. I mean, the first place I came was Toronto when I was 5. And I went everywhere with him. I performed with him when I was 6, 7, 8, in front of big crowds, like 90,000 plus. It was a blessing, really, because I appreciate that. Obviously, a lot of people, like, would love the chance to be able to travel. I was able to travel, like, everywhere.
22-year-old son, now he's coming on to the music scene, the rap world.
That's right.
So do we have Apache number 2 on our hands?
Yeah, you know, but, you know, as I said, he's grown up. I had him when I was 18, so even before I was an artist, so he ended up touring everywhere with me all over the world. Started performing with me in front of huge crowds when he was 5 and 6, right from, in fact, from America. He did 4 states in America when he was 7 years old. He did 6 cities in Japan, 94, another 6 in 95, all over India. And I knew that if, you know, eventually he would develop his own style. Then he was just kind of joining with me with a few songs. He developed his own style. His name's Kayview. It is hip-hop, it's rap. He's already had 3 mixtapes out in the UK, people know him.
Being Apache Indian's son, did you feel like you had more to prove to everyone that, hey, I am talented?
Right. To be honest, we was very conscious that problem would come up, that people would just assume I was there because of who he was. Mm-hmm. So what we did was, where I'm from in Birmingham, I actually came through on the scene without mentioning who he was. So I was getting played.
A lot of people do that when they have celebrity parents.
That's what I did, and I kind of earned my respect from the ground up. And people found out who I was on their own. It wasn't put across that way, oh, I'm Apache Indian's son. It was, I'm Kayview, listen to me. And when they, you know, when I started building a following, obviously people find out. But then it's all right, because they already liked me for who I was anyway.
Your son stepping into the music world, being his father, do you want to protect him and kind of stop him from making mistakes, or do you just want him to learn on his own?
No, absolutely. I mean, at the moment, I've let him develop his own style. You know, it's not about holding his hand. I haven't put him on TV, I haven't done a song with him, nothing. So he's had to find himself. But obviously, since he's entered the game, the actual industry, I'm there to protect him. If he makes a mistake that I've made, I haven't done my job. So hopefully I can guide him through that. He will make mistakes, he will have situations, but, you know, I'm here for that. I've had 20 years experience. We know who to talk to, how to do things. So hopefully he won't make those mistakes.
Can you give us a bit of a sample, a little rap?
You want a rap?
Yeah, just a little rap.
All right, check it. See, we could go blow for blow, partner. I'm trying to make some money, but the rap game's messy like road drama. And if the label won't help, then I'll blow up myself. Like the USA,
you're the government psychologist, they the cleverest. Got the kids thinking every Muslim's a terrorist. My intelligence never lives high like Everest. We've on the beat so effortless.
And with Kayview kicking off his career in the rap world, does that mean Apache is getting ready to retire? Nope, not by a long shot.
You will get reward in your life, and for every day that you get up and you do something wrong, it will always come back until you learn your lesson. Live and direct, right here. Me, Apache Indian, Omni.
So be sure to swing by your local CD store to get a copy of Apache Indian's latest CD, Time for Change. I'm Monica Dogra, and that's a wrap on entertainment.